So let me get this right. You're considering moving to the sunny town of Pleasanton, California. Well, then we need to talk because I've got 17 items you need to know first before you live in the town of Pleasanton, and it starts right now. Hi, I'm Warren Oberholzer with RE/MAX Accord. I'm located in the East Bay Tri-Valley area in Northern California. My channel's about helping both buyers and sellers get maximum results for one of their biggest investments, their home. All right, let's get the blah, blah, blah over with first. My wife and I moved to the town of Pleasanton about 40 years ago. We raised our two beautiful children here, and we love this area. We love the city. We love everything it has, and that's true. But you know what? It may not be right for you, and that's why we've got to go through all 17 items first before you know if it's right for you to move here and live here. Now, before you decide to bounce out and go to another YouTube video, how do I know you'll do that? Because I watch YouTube all the time and I ricochet out to other videos. I want you to realize that to assess a city, to assess a place to move to, it's a big decision. I get that. So if you watch all the way through, I guarantee you it's going to be interesting. I'm not going to get into a lot of boring facts. I'm going to make it kind of compelling, a little humor, whatever. I think you'll enjoy it. However, if you do leave, please mark someplace where you saw this and come back and revisit it because it may take a few times to go through to see if this is the right place for you. Of course, you need to come to the town and do that as well. But anyway, that's what I would recommend navigating through all of your choices you have on YouTube. By the way, what's your next YouTube video? I've been looking at some drag races ones. They're really cool. Okay, I'm just kidding. Here are the 17 items you need to know first before living in the town of Pleasanton. Number one, Pleasanton's neighborhoods. Pleasanton's communities and neighborhoods are beautiful, quiet, and safe. I have posted several property tour videos that feature a specific Pleasanton neighborhood. The key items that separate one neighborhood from the other is the age and size of the property, and of course, the cost. You'll find the majority of the properties in Pleasanton are in good order. Pleasanton has a few gated communities. The two main ones are Golden Eagle Estates and Ruby Hill. You'll find links below to the ones I've already posted. Number two, weather. Pleasanton has amazing weather. There's no snow, there's no fog, and there's no humidity. Yes, it does get hot in the summer, and occasionally temperatures can go over 100 degrees. However, it usually starts cooling off between 5 to 6 p.m., and again, there's no humidity and no mosquitoes. The winter months are pretty mild here. The biggest rainfall month is February, with an average total of 3.6 inches. Okay, I said I wasn't gonna get boring, and I'm getting boring, so we'll pick it up. This is a tough crowd. Hey, before I leave weather, I want you to know, again, no snow, and that means that the roads aren't salted in the winter, which means there's not gonna be any kind of corrosion to your car. Number three, cost of housing. Pleasanton by far is not the cheapest area to live. However, if you compare the average price of a 1,500 square foot home in Pleasanton and compare that to a comparable property in the South Bay area, such as Sunnyvale, Mountain View, Menlo Park, Cupertino, these are the cities that have the tech headquarters for companies like Google, Apple, LinkedIn, Facebook, etc. You'll see Pleasanton's average sales cost is a little over $1 million, which is $668 a square foot. But the South Bay cities I just mentioned, the average sales price is about $1,900,000, which is $1,300 a square foot. That's almost twice the price for a comparable home in Pleasanton. Now, wait a minute. I know you're thinking this is boring, but it's not. When we're talking about money, it's compelling. All right, talk show Warren, take it away. Number four, Pleasanton's commute. Pleasanton's known as a bedroom community, which means it's a suburb inhabited largely by people who commute to other cities for work. What the heck does that mean? Let's just say if you live in this town, you most likely don't work here. So where are the cities you'd commute to?
Well, as I just mentioned in the cost of housing, the South Bay, which is Sunnyvale, Mountain View, Menlo Park, Cupertino. This is only a 30-minute drive from Pleasanton. However, in commute time, it can take up to 2 hours each way. This sucks. Fortunately, there's several ways you can get there in style and comfort. One way is the commuter bus. Many tech companies offer their own commute coach bus. They usually have comfortable seats with Wi-Fi. There is also the ACE train. Once you get there, you can take a Lyft or an Uber to your location. Some companies offer private shared buses that offer regular scheduled pickup and drop-off services. Now, if you're going to Oakland to San Francisco area, there's BART. Let me give you an example. My wife works in Emeryville, which is a city next to Oakland. She's been there over 8 years. She's never driven once. She takes BART every day she goes to work. Number five, Pleasanton is close to everything. If you like skiing, hiking, and camping, we have the spectacular Sierra Mountain Range, which is located in the beautiful Lake Tahoe area. It's approximately a 3 to 4 hour drive from Pleasanton. If you like the beaches, we have Santa Cruz, which is about an hour away. And if you want to do some sightseeing like in the San Francisco area, that too is about an hour away. When my wife and I want to change the scenery, we'll go visit the famous San Francisco Pier 39 Fisherman's Wharf area. To make it easy, we'll just take the BART train right from the Pleasanton station. And this means I don't have to have the hassle of driving in and the headache of trying to park. Now, if you're in the mood for wine tasting, the Napa Wine County is just 2 hours away. Number six, local activities. Let's start with golf. We have numerous public golf courses in and around Pleasanton that are no more than a 25-minute drive. Now, let's talk about wineries. You don't have to go up to Napa. We have the Livermore Wineries, and they're just 25 minutes away from Pleasanton. Pleasanton also has great bike and walking paths. Pleasanton has 44 community and neighborhood parks. Most of these parks I've already featured in previous videos, which you can find the links below. Pleasanton also has approximately 24 miles of trails and 600 acres of undeveloped space. Number seven, Pleasanton's downtown. Pleasanton's downtown Main Street area has numerous activities such as their famous Saturday morning farmers market, their weekend street fairs, and parades. To find out more about upcoming events, please see the Downtown Association link below. Number eight, the Alameda County Fairgrounds. They host several events throughout the year to include the annual county fair, the Summer Car Good Guys Show, and in the fall, they have the haunted theme park Pirates of Emerson, which is a Halloween tradition. And during the fair season, they have horse races. Number nine, restaurants. Pleasanton has numerous restaurants along their downtown Main Street area. You'll find a variety to include Asian, Greek, Italian, and Mexican foods. To really appreciate all the charm and unique restaurants and stores Main Street has to offer, just take a stroll down the street and make sure you include both sides. You don't want to miss anything. You'll also find several shopping strip malls that feature popular chain restaurants such as Chili's, Panda Express, and Habit Burger. Number 10, Pleasanton Stone Ridge Shopping Mall. This is a beautiful laid out indoor mall. They host numerous chains like Apple Store and Macy's. They also have restaurants such as P.F. Chang's, The Cheesecake Factory, and California Pizza Kitchen. Number 11, San Francisco Dining and Entertainment. You're just an hour away whether you choose to drive or take BART. Now, there are numerous restaurants along Fisherman's Wharf, the Cannery, and Pier 39. And of course, once you get to know the San Francisco area, you'll find numerous restaurants throughout the city. For entertainment, you have many events to choose from, such as plays, concerts, and sporting events. Now, don't think you have to spend any money to have a good time. You can find amazing street performers in and around the Pier 39 area. And one item I must mention before I leave this is the annual San Francisco Fleet Week event. It's usually held the second week in October, and it concludes on the weekend by the spectacular aerial performance by the Navy's Blue Angels. This event, again, is free. However, I do recommend you take BART in due to the traffic and trying to find a place to park. Number 12, great schools. One of the biggest selling features for families in Pleasanton is their award-winning schools. No need to go to private schools, their public schools are excellent. You'll find a link below for all the school information. Number 13, Pleasanton is a super pet-friendly town. Again, Pleasanton has numerous parks, and these parks are all dog-friendly. Now, if you'd like your dog to run off-leash, we do have Cubby's Dog Park. As you go through the city, you'll see everyone walking their dog around the neighborhood. On most Saturdays, weather permitting, at the Main Street Farmers Market, there's Pet Adoption Day. Number 14, Pleasanton's freeways. Pleasanton has easy access to the two freeways that surround the town, which are 580 and 680. To help assist in the traffic hours, both freeways have been upgraded with commute and toll lanes. Number 15, the Bay Area's professional sports teams. For baseball, we have the San Francisco Giants and the Oakland Athletic A's. If you don't want to drive and hassle with parking, you can take BART right from Pleasanton. It'll go straight into Oakland. And for San Francisco, there's a Muni Metro transfer, and it'll take you right to the stadium. For For football, we have the San Francisco 49ers. They play at their new state-of-the-art Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. For ice hockey, we have the San Jose Sharks, which play in San Jose. And for basketball, last but not least, we have the Golden State Warriors, which are just about to move to their brand new stadium in San Francisco. Number 16, California property taxes. Under Prop 13, the annual real estate tax on a parcel of property is limited to 1% of its assessed value.
This property tax segment, it's going to be boring. We're going to take it out.
Wait a minute. I got this. You need to understand, this 1% limits the amount of how much the state can raise your taxes per year. Here's an example. Let's say you purchased a property in California for $200,000 and your annual property taxes are $2,500 a year. Now, providing you still live in that same house, let's say you stay there for 30 years and it appreciates to $1.2 million. Yes, it can happen, especially in Pleasanton. Your annual property taxes after 30 years will be approximately $4,600, as opposed to being taxed on the current assessed value, which would be $15,000 per year. You'll find this is a big California homeowner benefit. Okay, we good?
Cool.
And last but not least, number 17, Pleasanton is a very friendly and community-focused town. Probably one of the main features that separates Pleasanton apart from other towns is its local connection with its community. As I discussed earlier, their downtown Main Street area hosts numerous events throughout the year, from street fairs, farmers market, Friday night concerts, parades, etc. But that's just the tip of the iceberg. Pleasanton offers much more. The City of Pleasanton Recreation Department has several different sports programs to include basketball, baseball, soccer, swimming, skateboard, tennis, outdoor hockey, golf, the list keeps going. They have programs for all ages, from kids to adults. Now, due to our current COVID-19 environment, all sporting activities are on hold. To find out more, please see the links below. One more item to mention for the performing arts is the Firehouse Arts Center. They host numerous types of events to include concerts and plays.
So, when you put this all together, you've got a good-sized city that has a small-town feel. Hey, I hope you enjoyed this. For more information on Pleasanton, please send me an email request for my Moving to the Town of Pleasanton guide.
Thanks so much for watching. Now that you've watched this video, you may want to watch these other related ones. Please post any questions or comments you may have below. I usually can get back to you within 24 hours.
If you like this video, please subscribe and hit the like button. It does help support my channel. And stay tuned. I have more helpful videos like this coming soon. Thank you so much for watching.